Here we go. Now, obviously, this is unlicensed, so if you want it, you'd have to activate it, install it in Windows. Here we go. And this is what we got over here. It's the usual. Your PC may start restart several times. Yeah. God, am I? I mean, it's. I went back 20 years ago, and we've always had Windows around. I've always had to have Windows around for certain things. You know, there's just things you have to have it around for. But I've never used it on a day-to-day basis since the last version of Windows. That was by main Windows, I think it was Windows NT. That sort of dates me. No, it might be Windows 98. No, 98 NT. And then I switched to Mac. I switched to Mac pretty much when those iMacs came out, the ones that were all the plasticky things. I think the problem we had, all our 3D software, because back then I was doing 3D, was on Windows. So Lightwave, Softimage and all that only ran on Windows. So if you were doing 3D, you had to stick to it. But then over time, that's all drifted over, hasn't it? So over time, you've ported and editing software. Mac, what did Mac have? No, it had Final Cut, obviously. But you Avid, did Avid run on it? I think Avid ran on it as well. But yeah, it was the early days of Premiere as well. So everything was basically easier to do on Windows by then, but that's obviously just changed so dramatically now because there's such parity with software across platforms apart from Linux. But we're getting there. It's getting there. There'll come a day when you just don't need to do this. And it's great to see laptops going on sale now that are pre-installed with Linux. I know that System 76 do their laptops. Tux, there's another couple of laptop manufacturers now put out, and Dell did it, didn't they, for a while. They put out pre-installed Linux. And obviously a framework laptop works perfectly with Omarchy. I just did my son's machine, but I had to switch that back to Windows, sadly, because they don't use Linux at school. That would throw him slightly. But yeah, so I mean, it's getting there, but it's great that you can virtualize. I remember we used to have a lot of trouble doing this kind of stuff. It was a lot of steps to get virtualization going, and you'd need like a proper techie guy to do this stuff. But yeah, I mean, it's... you know, a lot of systems now that you buy a big piece of hardware.